We now move on to the leader's questions. Could I call on Deputy Micheál Martin?
Thank you, John Corlin. Taoiseach, 31,000 discretionary medical cards have been taken from very sick children and very sick people with life-limiting and life-threatening and terminal conditions over the last 3 years. And I've raised this issue with you over the last 18 months on various occasions on leaders' questions. And you've consistently denied that there's been any change of policy or that there's been any move to limit and to get rid of discretionary medical cards. And indeed, the government's position became very farcical when the Minister himself for State, Alex White, actually went on radio and said there's no such entity as a discretionary medical card. That would have done justice to any North Korean leader in terms of sort of trying to eliminate the truth and the factual situation. The Health Service Plan, Taoiseach, actually set a target to reduce discretionary medical cards. And every TD in the House at this stage has been inundated with calls from very worried parents and families who have lost medical cards. I have another list of 10 people here, Taoiseach, that I can give to you in terms of very serious conditions. A 12-year-old child, one in six in the world with a particular syndrome, denied a medical card, with appalling conditions arising out of that particular syndrome. A 65-year-old woman with multiple myeloma, a terminal condition, had the card for some years removed from her. And many, many other cases like that. There was an incredible report in the Irish Independent, Taoiseach, where the mother of Ben Hughes was told, could you please prove that your child still has Down syndrome? It's just extraordinary stuff. And we learned that from the CEO of the Down Syndrome Ireland that half of children with Down syndrome have either been affected by this call on discretionary medical cards or have lost them. And then there's the letter of the specialist nurses from the Jack and Jill Foundation, Taoiseach, to the Minister for Health. And these are nurses who are looking after children with life-limiting and life-threatening conditions and children who need 24-hour care.
Question, please.
And they're saying the situation has become particularly vicious over the past 2 years. The situation is critical. It's only a matter of time before somebody, most likely a stressed out parent, is pushed over the edge by this unjust system. We see the danger signs already out there. Parents worn out, reduced to tears, not sleeping, not coping, and worried out of their minds in relation to their child's medical card. Now, all of us have actually met such parents.
Thank you.
All of us in this house have met such parents, Taoiseach. And what I want to ask you, Taoiseach, will you, for God's sake, intervene in this scandal? And it's a scandal that's been going on now for the last 2 years. It is utterly shameful. And most people you meet, irrespective of whether they have medical cards or not, are saying, will you, for God's sake, on reflection of a decent society, look after the sickest, look after those who need medical cards, and make them your priority. Will you intervene, Taoiseach, and reverse engines on this and transform the situation from what it is?
Thank you, Taoiseach.
Thanks, Deputy Martin, for his question. I recall back in 2002. Just to remind you. No, you don't. You never.
Hold on a minute.
Thank you. Thank you. I always like to remind Deputy Martin of the truth. Deputy Healy Race, a very important element in Irish life. In 2002, Deputy Micheál Martin promised the electorate 200,000 extra medical cards. By the time you left the Department of Health in 2004, it was estimated that 100,000 low-income individuals had lost eligibility. Now, that's your record. Now, first of all, let me say to you, Deputy Martin,
please.
This question of medical cards, of discretionary cards, of long-term illness cards, of cards for children or people with particular difficulties, of cards for emergency situations, are all very serious, because they impact on the quality of life that people have and the stress and anxiety that it causes. A great number of our people who have full medical cards haven't used them for quite some time. Because as you well know, The medical card, the legislation governing medical cards, is based on financial hardship and not on medical condition. And the situation was that over the country, community welfare officers in different parts of the country used their judgment in different ways to allow medical cards or not. That's the way that it was. So, thank you, Deputy OD. So you centralised all of this with the same criteria applicable to everybody, and that's where the problem has arisen, because the centralisation doesn't take into account the particular circumstances that might apply in any individual case. Now, I'll just give you an example here. When Minister Riley became Minister for Health, he requested a detailed examination, Deputy, of the 78,000 people who held a medical card on a discretionary basis in March of 2011, and to see what the current situation of those 78,000 is in March of 2014. And of the 77,925 discretionary medical cards in circulation on the 1st of March 2011, their status on the 1st of March this year, 33% still held a medical card on a discretionary basis, 25,398. 49% of those now have a full medical card based on an assessment of means, 37,906 people. You may laugh at them if you want. There are 37,906 people with a full medical card. 19% no longer hold a medical card. That's 14,621, which was made up of 3% of those people who were deceased. 7% did not respond at all to correspondence. 2% did not complete the review process. And 7% completed the review process and were found to be ineligible for a medical card. Now, I think it's important to say, Deputy Martin, that one of the key goals of the reform of the health system is to ensure that people who have challenges here can get the integrated package of services of care that are built around their particular needs. That means that if the HSE, on the basis of the current legislation, which says this is based on financial hardship, even where they allow discretion, I have cases myself of where families, good luck to them, may well be very much in excess of the income limit, where there might be very high earners. And no matter how far you extend the discretion, you're still going to be short of the particular cases. So when I hear the campaigns saying to me, you must allow a full medical card for persons with a particular need or a particular category, because they might have it for life or they might not, but that they should deserve it for their life. That means if you apply that logic, everybody who will become a diabetic might be eligible for a card. Everybody who's an asthmatic will have a card. All of that. So I think we need a discussion about this, and I do take into account the many cases that deputies have raised here. And nobody should be asked a question, is your child still Down syndrome or not? Or nobody should be asked a question. Nobody should be asked a question. Nobody should be asked a question, Deputy McGrath. Nobody. I cannot defend somebody in whatever office, sending out a reply to a person who suffers from motor neuron disease to say, are you still suffering from motor neuron disease? This is what we have to get right. And this is where Minister Riley and the people are working to ensure that the package of services and facilities are put around and made available to those people in their particular difficulties. I understand deputies raising the question of discretionary cards. Giving you the figures 2 years on from 3 years on from 2011, but I just want you to understand that it's not an attempt here to show lack of understanding or compassion or consideration for people who have these challenges. It's to get a system that is fair for everybody. I had it myself over the years. How come this person gets a medical card and I can't have one? How come this was allowed and it's not allowed in my group? If you're going to have the standard, then we need to look at what we're doing here. If it's on the basis of financial hardship, well then, apply discretion as far as you can, but put the local integrated package around people who need it and see that they get that care and attention.
Deputy Martin, thank you.
Taoiseach, we're not talking about any old case. People who had discretionary medical cards, Taoiseach, had them under the legislation. I'm talking about Taoiseach. I think most people watching Taoiseach, or most people out there in society, would expect a 12-year-old child who has profound mental disability, who's legally blind, who has hearing loss in the left ear, who's asthmatic, who's non-verbal, and who's wheelchair-bound to have a medical card, Taoiseach. That's my point. I'm not talking about systems or integration this or integration that. Most people in society say, what in the name of God is going on when a child like that doesn't have a medical card? And equally, Taoiseach, I would say to you that in terms of a 65-year-old woman who's multiple cirrhosis, osteoarthritis, congenital abnormality of the eyes, and other conditions, I think most people would say that person should have a medical card. And equally, Taoiseach, in terms of an elderly woman with multiple myeloma, had the card since 2006.
Question, please.
The terminal condition, but had the card removed. See, you see, Taoiseach, it's a policy. Enormous stress has been called. Last night I called to a door, Taoiseach, and I'm not going to name the
Deputy,
case.
We're over time, please.
Motor neuron case, on a ventilator. Incredible care being shown to the person by a loved one. The card is only renewed for 6 months. I mean, this thing is out of control, Taoiseach. It's a disgrace. I think you should hang your head in shame.
Put your question, please.
You should hang your head in shame, Taoiseach, at a policy that is actually focused on taking cards from people who need it. And the legislation is there to allow it. And you've been warned enough now by many, many people on your own side, on the back benches, and deputies from every other party here. This calls for a genuine intervention, Taoiseach. And by the way, the letter from the Jack and Jill specialist nurses was sent to you. And they made a very good point. They said the government should be rolling out the red carpet to parents who are prepared to look after their children in very serious conditions at 24-hour basis. Not rolling out red tape.
Thank you.
Because that's what's happening right now. And they're in dread of the next letter that will come their way, asking them, your card is under review, would you please fill in all the forms? That's what's happening, Taoiseach. For God's sake, will you do something about
Thank
it,
you.
Intervene and stop it?
Taoiseach.
Well, let me assure Deputy Martin that you're not the arbiter of all things that are just and fair in the country. Your own record speaks for itself, which was disgraceful. Now, I called in the HSE and the Minister for Health and everybody else to discuss these questions because deputies on this side of the House were bringing to our attention very serious cases. But I haven't heard you say, Deputy Martin, I haven't heard you say that the law should be changed from what it is at the moment, where it's based on financial hardship. Now, I have a case, I've got a case here myself.
Please, it's a time.
If you want to change the legislation, if you decide, let's have a conversation about it. If you want to decide to change the legislation to base it on medical needs as distinct from income and financial hardship that flows from that, well, then we're entering a very different sphere here. A very different sphere, Deputy Martin. So what we're trying to do here is to ensure that people who need care and attention and facilities and aids for their particular difficulties get them. But of course there are differences of opinion and perception about the medical card, the long-term illness card, the discretionary card given in exceptional circumstances, the emergency card given, and people who have particular difficulties
Thank
for
you.
All their lives. I said to Deputy over here, I don't believe in a case of the HSE asking somebody 6 months further on, have they still got motor neuron? That is not what we want. Yes, I understand. And that's why we've intervened here to put a stop to that. And just like other cases where centralized digital recording took place, these cases come to light all the time. And each time they do, we try to deal with them with a sense of compassion. Now, Minister Riley is going to meet with
Thank
the
you.
Nurses from the Jack and Jill Foundation to go through these cases so that the state can say, of course we understand that people have particular difficulties, some of them for life. I've got a case here of motor neuron myself, who suctioned 10 times a day, but is very much over the limit. What are you to do? Do you say, everybody gets a card here? Of course the 24 hours care.
Thank
24
you.
Hours, can't speak, can't walk, can't do anything. Of course, in our nation's history, you never want to see a situation where they're left without attention or without medical care.
Thank you.
You refuse to focus on the fundamental issue that we're trying to deal with here. The law has been there for very many years. It's been there for very many years, Deputy Martin. And that's why probably back in 2002, you disgraced yourself with another promise that you couldn't keep.
Thank you.
I'm giving you the figures of discretionary cards from 2011 to 2014. And we will continue to show a compassion and understanding where that is possible in all these circumstances.
Now, I would ask you, please, to have an understanding of the chair. That question went 7.5 minutes over the time allocated. Now, if you want to extend the time allowable, please do so. But don't have me shouting at you to please finish. That's all. I only apply the rules. So would the whips ever get together and look at this issue so that we can have some flexibility that I will not will stop having to call on people to sit down. But I can't just allow things to drift on and say nothing. Now, would you please, Deputy Adams, and then I have to try and be fair to everybody. So, Deputy Adams, I depend on your general...